Hi, this is Jitendra Pal Singh, and in this video I will share with you that how you can get free web hosting and a subdomain name for your website. So open your browser and type www.hostinger.com. You will see this website. When you will scroll down, you will see different kind of flags on your screen. You need to select your country flag from these flags. As I am an Indian, so I'm going to click on India. When I will click on India, I will have Indian website related to Hostinger. Now I'm going to close this tab, and here on this website, on its homepage, you can see there is a title free hosting. So to register on this website, I need to click on order now. And when you will scroll down, you will see a registration form. You need to fill this registration form with your name, your email address, your password, and re-enter your password here. Now scroll down and click on I am not a robot, and make sure that you have ticked on I agree to terms of services, and then click on create account. You will get this kind of message: registration is almost complete. Please check your email address and click on the account activation link. So check your email address. You will receive two emails in your account. So click on the first email address, sign up confirmation. Here you will see a message that you need to click on the following link to activate your profile. When you will click on that link, you will get a message: registration is complete, now you can create accounts. Now we need to select a hosting plan for us. Here you can see there are three hosting plans: free, premium and business. You can read the details regarding each hosting plan here and then select your plan. As I want a free web hosting, so I will choose free plan here and I will click on order button. On this page, you will select your domain name and password for your website. Here you can see, choose a domain type. If you already have a domain, then you can enter here, or you need to select a subdomain name option from here, and you will choose your subdomain name here. Enter the subdomain name you want and then select from these options. I'm going to select pe.hu. Then from here you need to select a server for your website. There are five options available here. From these, UK is the default and free option. So remain this option selected and select your password from this option. Enter your password and then confirm your password here and then click on continue button. So when you will click on continue button, you will get this kind of message on your screen that they are receiving more than 20,000 new activations each day. So they want you to describe that why you want to register free here on our website. So you can write anything, as I'm going to write that I want to check how free web hosting works. That's why I want to register here. Now scroll down and tick on this option that I am not a robot. When I am clicking on this option, I am getting green tick. But you may get different kind of images on your screen and a title that please select those images which are having cats or mountains. So according to the title, you need to select the images which are having cats or the images which are having mountains. Or there may be another option. So I am lucky that I am not getting that kind of captchas on my screen. But when I tried earlier on this website, I was getting that captcha images. So that's why I am sharing this experience with all of you. Now scroll down and click on this button, order. When you will click on order button, you will get this message on your screen that account jitenderwebsite.pe.hu has been created successfully. So I am going to copy it and enter it in your new tab to open your website. Now here you can see that I am getting this message that your account has been created, means my account is ready and this is my subdomain name. Now I will simply upload my website here on this domain name. Here you can see I am getting this message: website successfully installed on the server. Please delete default.php from the public_html folder. So I need to delete the default.php file. This is the default.php file which I need to delete from public_html folder with the help of FileZilla. FileZilla is a FTP software which is used to upload your website from local computer to online server. Go to the Google and search FileZilla download. You will get many links. Click on any link to download this software and then install FileZilla. I already installed in my system, so I'm going to close this tab and I'm going to run FileZilla. So here it is. As I shared with you that this is a software which lets your computer to connect to your online server, on the left hand side you can see my drives. This is my computer which is showing all of my drives here, C, D, E and F. And on the right hand side, this is a server. Here you can see local site and remote site. Local site means your computer and remote site means your server. Here you can see we are getting message that we are not connected to any server. That's why we are not able to see any file on the remote side, as you can see on the left hand side. So now I am going to create a connection to my online server. For that, go to the file and click on site manager, or click on this icon to open your site manager. Here you can see I already managed a different kind of websites here. We are going to set up a new site here. So click here and enter your name, anything. I'm going to enter Jitendra_website, and here you need to enter the hostname of your website or the domain name of your website. So I'm going to copy and paste it here, and under the protocol you need to select FTP, and from encryption select the first option, FTP over TLS, and from login type select normal and enter your username and password here. You will get this username and password in your email address. So for that, check your email. Let me check my first email, sign up email. This is a very simple email where they notify us that you registered with this email address and this password on their website. So let's check the second email with subject free account activated. Here you will get your all details regarding your website. When you will scroll down, you will see details regarding your FTP, your host name, your username, your password. Now from here you need to copy the FTP host name. So copy this and paste it here under the host. You can enter the domain name or the FTP host name here. And now select the username. From here, select the username and paste it here. And enter the password. And then click on OK button to save this site. Now to connect this site, you need to go to the site manager again, and from these you can select the website you want to connect. I'm going to select the Jitendra_website. So click here and then connect. Here it is. Now you can see I'm successfully connected to my online server. That's why I'm able to see my files on the right hand side, I mean on remote side. Now the next step is to delete the default.php file from public_html folder. So this is my public_html folder and this is my default.php file. Now I'm going to delete this file from this folder. So to delete this file, I need to right click here and select delete and then yes. Now refresh it here. So now you can see the index of your website here. What I will do now, I will simply upload my website on this domain and refresh it here, then you will see my website online. But I don't have any website right now on my computer. So for that, I will go to the Google and type free website templates. You will get many links. But this one is my favorite, allfreedownload.com. So click here to download any template that you like. I'm going to select this one, break even template. Click here and then you will see a green button on the right hand side, free download this file now. Click here to download this file, and here you can see a zip file is downloading. After completion of download, go to the folder and cut it from here and paste it on your desktop or wherever you want to paste. And after that, extract these files into a folder. So now open this folder, and here you can see the images of this website, the index file and the CSS file. Let me browse this file to you. Here you can see, this is the website template which I just downloaded in front of you. Now let's suppose that you have created this website on your local computer and you want to upload this website on your domain name. So what you need to do, with the help of FTP, you can upload your files from local server to online server. So for that, open FileZilla, and I need to reconnect it here because connection closed. Click connect. Okay. Once you will get successful message on your screen again, go to the path where you placed your website, desktop, this is the folder, breakeven_2525. Open this folder and then select all of your files, images, HTML file, CSS file, all of these files. So for that, press Ctrl A from your keyboard and then make sure that on the right hand side you are on the location public_HTML folder. And then right click and click on upload to transfer your files from local server to online server. I mean from your local computer to online server. At the bottom you can see files are transferring. And after completion, refresh it here on your domain name. And here you can see your website is online with your HTML file, with CSS, with your images. So this was the tutorial related to free web hosting and a subdomain name for your website. In the upcoming videos, I will share with you that how you can get a free email address for your website, how to upload a database website, I mean the website which are having databases, and the WordPress website. So stay tuned and put like on this video if you really like this video, and share it as much as possible, and also subscribe to my channel for my upcoming videos. Thanks for watching. Take care.